Have you ever noticed that whenever you need to use a modifier on your keyboard, like Shift, Control, or Alt, you need to twist your wrist or accurately curl your fingers? And don't get me started on having to press more than one modifier at once. It's painful to even look at someone doing it, like Control, Shift, Alt, W. What's this? Fortunately, there are not one, but two ways to avoid that. Roll intro! Hi, I'm Mikel, and I'm here today to save your fingers from looking like this. As I mentioned, there are two ways to avoid that.
1. Get a programmable keyboard and use homebrew modifiers. 2. Get an ergonomic keyboard with extra thumb keys and use them as modifiers. Or you can do both.
Let's start with homebrew modifiers. First, we'll need to answer the question, what are homebrew modifiers? As the name hints, it's placing the modifiers like Control, Alt, or Shift in the home row.
But where is the home row?
Good question, Anna.
You are fired!
The home row is where your fingers rest on the keyboard when you're not typing. On a traditional QWERTY layout, that's ASDF and JKL semicolon. So, A could be the Windows key or Command, S could be Alt or Option, Shift could be D, and F could be Control. But if we move the modifiers there, how do we type those keys? That's where a programmable keyboard, like the Dimarace 2, comes in. You see, with the exception of the Windows or Super key, all modifiers work when you hold that key. For example, you hold Control and press C to copy. With a programmable keyboard, you can configure a key to do one thing when tapped and a different thing when held. This is called Mod Tap on Q and K or Add a Key on Tap on our Digma keyboards. For example, if I tap D, I get D. But if I hold it and then press J, I get a capital J. For the Digma keyboards, configuring home row modifiers is as simple as opening Basecore, selecting the key, choosing the modifier, and then pressing Add a Key on Tap to do precisely that. Finally, press Save to send the changes to the keyboard. The big advantage of home row modifiers is that you get rid of all that finger movement and awkward curling when using modifiers. For example, as I've shown, capital J is this. You are not moving your fingers from the home row, or capital I. Very easy. Or Control Copy. You do Control Copy. You see, you're not moving your fingers to the bottom row to do Control Copy or capital J. You don't have to move your fingers from the home row. You can press any modifier or combination of modifiers without leaving the home row or contorting your fingers. For example, Control Shift. You can press them with these two fingers instead of Control Shift and then having to press any other key. Another benefit is that they free up space in the keyboard for macros or layer keys. If you want to know what layers are and how they can help you improve your ergonomics and productivity, check out this other video. However, there are some drawbacks. The main one is that you almost always need to use both hands. As I show, you cannot capitalize the letter D if you use the letter D for Shift. This is okay for capitalizing letters, as you should be doing that anyway. Ideally, you should be pressing Shift with your left and the key that you want to capitalize with your right, and use the right Shift to capitalize a letter on the left. But this is not so great for shortcuts, especially when your right hand is using the mouse and you want to use shortcuts with your left hand. If F is Control, how do you do Control F with one hand? You can't. Or Control T. You cannot do that with the same finger. You need to move your hand and do that, it becomes awkward. Another thing to consider is that getting used to home row modifiers requires some serious muscle memory retraining. But most importantly, home row modifiers can lead to mistypes. Most of us roll our keys when typing. That means that we press the next key before fully releasing the previous one, which can accidentally trigger the modifier. For example, when typing AS, we press the S before fully releasing the A. Fortunately, you can fine-tune some settings to avoid that. For the Digma keyboards, you can go to Preferences, Typing and Keys on Basecore, and adjust different settings. If you want to avoid accidental modifier triggers, we recommend setting up the overlap threshold to 100% and the minimum hold time to 90 milliseconds. This might mean that you'll need to hold the modifier longer to activate it. For example, I might need to hold D a little longer to be able to capitalize the J. But you won't trigger it accidentally. You can play with these values to find your perfect setting. Another way to avoid these false triggers is to try different arrangements of the modifiers in the homebrew. Since there are four modifiers, Shift, Alt Option, Control, and Windows Command or Super, depending on your OS, you can arrange them differently. The following examples are for Windows. If you use Mac, you might want to swap Control for Command, as most Mac shortcuts use the Command key instead of Control. The first combination would be Shift, Control, Win, Alt. This one is the easiest to get used to, as the modifiers are placed in the same order as on a standard keyboard. However, you use your weakest fingers, the pinky and the ring, for the most used modifiers, such as Shift and Control. Another alternative is Win, Alt, Shift, Control. This is probably the most popular one. You use your strongest fingers, index and middle, for the most common modifiers, with Control and Shift. With Shift in the middle, you can easily do Shift Control or Shift Alt. If you want to use your strongest finger for Shift, that's the index, you can also swap Control and Shift to use your strongest finger, the index, for Shift. You would have Win, Alt, Control, and Shift. This is also a popular arrangement. Its main advantage is that it allows the most shortcuts with one hand, since now Control is on D instead of F. And it reduces the number of accidental capitalizations when rolling your keys, because Shift is the end of the rolling. You normally roll inwards and not outwards. Another way to avoid accidental triggers to the modifiers is to place them in a row below, on CXCV. There won't be homebrew modifiers anymore, and there will be more finger movement in both, since you have to reach to the row below. But it could be a reasonable trade-off. However, if you really want to avoid misfires, or you're looking for an alternative to homebrew modifiers that doesn't require so much muscle memory, you should try placing your modifiers in the thumb keys. If you think about it, we use our two strongest fingers, the thumbs, to press a single key, the spacebar.
Ew.
It's like tasking the Hulk to carry a bag of feathers. What if we could use our thumbs for all those pesky modifiers that we use to press with our pinky? That would be great.
Great success.
For that, you will need a keyboard with multiple thumb keys. Luckily, there are quite a few of those. Ideally, you will need at least four on each side, one per modifier. But we'll see later that three will do the trick just fine. Here are some keyboards that have at least three. The Korn and other similar DIY keyboards with three on each side. The Moonlander with four on each side, although one is not really easy to read, so let's say three. The Digmarace 2 with four on each side. The Keyboardio Model 100 with four on each side plus a pumpkin. The Glove 80 and the Kinesis Advantage 360 have six on each side, but half of them are not as easy to reach. And of course, the Digma Defy with eight on each side and at least four or five of them that are extremely easy to reach. Setting up a thumb key modifier is just as easy. Open VSCore, select the thumb key, go to Advanced Modifiers, choose the modifier, press Add a key on tab, assign the key, and finally press Save to send the changes to the keyboard. That way you can have space, backspace, or enter on tab, and modifiers on hold. As with the homebrew modifiers, there are different ways that you can arrange them. Here's one example. Shift is in the home thumb key, where you rest your thumb naturally, and Alt and Control are placed on either side. The Win key can be below or on either side of the thumb cluster. This way, you can press Shift Alt or Shift Control simultaneously with your thumb. Another option is to place Alt under Shift. That way, you have more combos that you can press with your thumb, like Alt Control, Alt Shift, Control Alt, and even the three of them at the same time. The most significant advantage of thumb key modifiers compared to homebrew modifiers is that the rest of the fingers are free to use modifiers comfortably with just one hand. That's great for triggering shortcuts with one hand while the other one uses the mouse. It also means that you don't need all the modifiers on both hands, which frees up space for layer keys. For example, this is how I have set it up, with modifiers mainly on the left side and layer shifts on the right side. As we've seen, it's also very easy to press two modifiers at once with your thumb. But most importantly, mistypes are far less frequent on thumb key modifiers, as you don't roll your keys as much when using space, enter, or backspace. Of course, you also need to retrain your muscle memory a bit, but it's much easier than with homebrew modifiers. And you need a keyboard with enough thumb keys, like ours.
Milhouse, lower those eyebrows.
So, when should you use each? Homebrew modifiers are great when your keyboard doesn't have enough thumb keys, like the Voyager? Maybe you want to reduce finger movement to the minimum? Or you have pain in your thumb and don't want to overload it. Nonetheless, if you have pain in your thumb, check how you place it on the keyboard. Some designs force you to bend it, causing discomfort. On the Defy instead, you can place it comfortably without having to curl it. Thumb key modifiers, on the other hand, are great when you want to access your modifiers easily with less retraining and fewer misfires. Or you use your keyboard with one hand a lot. However, the best solution can be a combination of both. You can use the thumb keys for modifiers and layer keys that you use the most, and you can use homebrew modifiers for secondary modifiers. For example, I use Mac, and I have all my main modifiers on the thumb keys, like Command, Alt, and Shift, but I have Control under F and J. On Mac, Control is rarely used, but it's great to navigate through tabs on Chrome with Control Tab. What is your approach? Do you use homebrew modifiers? Thumb key modifiers? Neither? Both? Let us know in the comments below. And of course, don't forget to press like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon. You don't want to miss great videos like this one.
So, choose wisely, and see you on the other side.